everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I've got this look for you, which is, with these colors I feel still, it's a bit of a dramatic look, but it's still quite wearable. Of course you could combine it with nude lips as well, which was actually my idea, but it just turned out darker than I anticipated it to, and I quite like it actually. But yeah, that's up to your own personal preference, of course. If you want to see more makeup tutorials by me and also chatty videos, some piercing related things, nail art and more dramatic makeup, and rarely also some less dramatic makeup, you can always subscribe to my channel. I'd really love it if you'd want to see more. And also, if you want to see pictures of makeup and also of my random daily life stuff, you can always follow me on Instagram as well. I'll put my name here somewhere. Other than that, I just wanted to mention that all the products that I use in this video, you can find them in the list below the video, in the video description, in case you want to know specific names and stuff like that. And that was all I had to say beforehand, so without further ado, let's get started. My eyebrows are already in place, and my eye primer is already in place as well, and I have a pretty decent plan this time as to what exactly I want to do, which is a rare thing for me. So yeah, let's just stop talking and actually start working. Okay, trying to dust off the mirror of a palette with a bralette is not working. I tried it so you don't have to. Now what I'm doing first, despite this look not containing any eyeliner as far as I'm planning, is using an eyeliner brush to apply a brown eyeshadow. And I'm pretty much making the shape of an eyeliner with that. You could do this in black eyeshadow as well, but I'm wearing these trousers and I just felt like matching the look with my clothes today. So I'm going for brown. And just applying it there. And now while I'm making sure to be above my natural crease so you can still see it with my eyes open, I'm just going to make it a wing. And just keep building up that color until it's nice and opaque. I'm blending out the crease towards my natural crease. Just because I do want to end up in my natural crease pretty quickly. And other than that, I'm just applying more eyeshadow and just sort of filling up the little wing shape a little bit. You can really do this with any eyeshadow you want, but I do recommend using an eyeshadow that's actually very pigmented. And also doesn't have too much fallout, because you don't want the brown to be everywhere, or whatever color you're using really. You don't want it to immediately be everywhere. I'm just gonna build up the color until I'm happy with it. Okay, that's all there. Now I'm going to do a pretty weird order of things. First off, I'm going to use a brow bone highlight, a very pale nude shade. What I'm doing now is using a pointy blending brush to really get a very pale taupe shade right next to the crease. Or at least the wing that I made. This is going to mean that I'm not going over the line, but I am applying it right above it. And then just blending it towards the brow bone. Just have a little bit more of a shadow there. Okay, but now the other eye has joined the game and this wing grew a little bit because I had to match it with the other eye and things just happen. And now I'm just grabbing a more fluffy brush to blend out the taupe shade. And in case you're wondering why I chose to do the taupe shade after the wing instead of before the wing, it would seem easier, but if you apply the eyeshadow directly on top of the base, it's just going to be more vibrant than if you apply it over top of other eyeshadow. And I really wanted the dark brown to be very vibrant, so that's why I made the decision to not go the easy way and instead do the wing first and then apply the color that's seemingly behind it afterwards. Yep. Now I'm applying a color that I can't describe anyway else than a puke shade. You can see what it looks like. I actually think it's a lovely color. I just don't know how to describe it in a not gross fashion. But I'm just applying it with a pointy brush so I can really be precise about where I put it. Yet it does apply it in a way that makes it still, you know, soft and easy to blend rather than to have it be a dark line that would be incredibly difficult to blend instead. Now I've grabbed the taupe shade again on the fluffy brush and I'm just blending out both the shade that I just applied and also the end of the wing here. Or the start of the wing, depending on how you look at it. Point is, I really only want the wing itself to be sharp and not anything surrounding it. So I'm just going to blend this until it's nice and soft. I'm just applying a shimmer shade on the eyelid and I'm actually going to apply multiples of them. This one is just going to be the first one third. And I'm just applying it with this sort of brush, which is quite a flat brush. And really the way it applies a shimmer resembles if you do it with your fingertips, but my nails are kind of long and I don't want to poke my own eyes out. Or anyone else's for that matter. For this sort of thing, I just prefer to play it safe and use a brush instead. Now I'm just applying a shimmer shade right around the edge of the wing, just because this particular shimmer shade, you know, it's like pretty much the color of the brown shade, but in shimmer glitter, more really of a pressed glitter than really just a shimmer. So I'm just applying it there to make it blend more easily. Now I'm just mixing both of the colors that I use, the color of the shimmer, because I want a color that's like the middle of those two and there isn't a color in the palette that is that way. So I'm just taking the easy solution and blend both of them together. And seeing as it's both of those colors blended together, it's also going to blend well with both colors. Yes, that's logic. I'm just applying that on the empty space I still had left. I wasn't going for a very cut crease-like effect, so I'm just going through it with the blender again, just to make it all nice and soft. Now, one thing you obviously want to do when you're applying foundation with a look like this is to really go around the edge of the wing with the foundation first. I'm actually going to use a concealer as a foundation, but whatever you're using. Take a small brush. Yes, this is the same brush I used for the shimmers, but I wiped it off on the face halo, so it's fine now. I try to not use too many brushes. But anyway, I just go around the wing first with this, just so I don't go over it with my beauty blender later on, or brush, or whatever you're going to use. Like, be precise with this. And then for the rest of my face, I am just going to use this concealer with my beauty blender, just because it's... That looks weird. Obviously a lot quicker. And then also, obviously, underneath my eyes. And then, of course, powder. And obviously, also try to avoid the wing with that. For the under eye, I'm just using the brush I used earlier, the pointy one, along with the shade that I also used on the wing. So the dark brown shade. And I'm just applying it and blending it with the same brush. Because I want to keep the under eye pretty simple, because I don't want to distract from the wing. Like so. I'm using, for contouring, the same shade in taupe that I've already used in, the shadow above the wing. Just because I'm already holding the palette at this point anyway. I'm using it on a tinier brush for my nose contour, and if you're also doing this with an eyeshadow, be very careful. Use like half a molecule of product for this, because obviously an eyeshadow is meant to be used as an eyeshadow and therefore is usually very pigmented. So it can easily get out of hand if you're not careful. For blush, I'm using a very pale peach shade, also actually an eyeshadow. But it's just one of those colors that will really fit with anything at all in terms of eye looks, lips and whatever. So yeah, perfect for anything. The highlighter I'm going to use, because, you know, like, if I'd use a shimmer shade from the eyeshadow palette, it would be a bit too glittery. So the highlighter is a separate one. It's a very pale gold shade. Still kind of shimmery, but a little bit more subtle. And I'm just applying it anywhere where I would usually highlight. Well, the false eyelashes, or at least the glue on those, is drying. I'm going to do my lips because, well, I want to do mascara afterwards, and otherwise we're just sitting here waiting. I gotta admit, this one is a bit more pinkish than I thought it would be, so I'm going to use a brownish lip gloss on top of it. The pair I'm going to use is quite natural and very, very worn down, but I think it can still work for one more time, or five more times maybe. Anyway, but mostly you have a clear lash band, so I don't need to use eyeliner in order to use these. Okay, those are on there. I'm just applying a nude pencil now, because I totally forgot to do that earlier. And then some mascara just to blend the eyelashes nicely together. And then lastly some setting spray and then we're completely done. And we're left with the final results. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And yeah, that was all I had to say for today. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!